I'm Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to do a quick static check on Yaskawa's CIMR-F7 series of inverters. Now, after the drive has been powered off for a while, we're going to go ahead and check the DC bus to make sure that it has been properly discharged. That way, there's no chance that we can get an accidental shock from the drive. So we're going to take our digital multimeter and put it on the DC mode and measure between the positive and the negative side of the DC bus. And it's looking like 0.8 volts, so that's fine. We wouldn't want to proceed any farther if we had more than 1 volt. We'd want to just wait some more time for the DC bus to discharge. Now the next thing we're going to be doing is checking the inputs and the outputs with the multimeter in the diode function. And at this point, we're going to be taking our positive side of our digital multimeter and placing it on the negative side of the DC bus and checking between T1, T2, and T3. We got 0.45, 0.45, 0.44. It's nice and balanced and in the right range. And then we're going to switch our digital multimeter leads around. We're going to put the negative side of the digital multimeter on the positive side of the DC bus. And then check again, 0.44, 0.44, 0.44. Depending on what size of drive you have, the ratings can change. But if they're between 0.2 and 1, they should be okay as long as they're balanced across all three phases. So let's go ahead and check the outputs using the same method. We'll take the positive side of the digital multimeter and put it on the negative side of the DC bus and go between U, V, and W. Nice and balanced at 3.8. We'll swap our leads. Check it again. 0.39, 0.39, 0.39. And again, nice and balanced across all three phases and within the correct range, so the inputs and outputs are checking good. Now the last thing that we're going to check is to see if any of the phases are shorted to ground. So we'll go ahead and put our digital multimeter on the ohms function. We're going to find a good ground and check all of the phases to make sure that none of them have gone to ground. Place your digital multimeter in the resistance function, put the negative side of the digital multimeter on the ground, and then you're going to want to check between L1, L2, L3, and U, V, and W. Will this drive pass all the static check? And there always still could be a problem with the drive, but if you found something inconsistent with what we just did here, there's obviously a problem and the drive will need to be sent in for repair. If you have any questions or for more help with troubleshooting your drives, please contact us at Precision Zone. We perform free evaluations and we'll provide a 12-month warranty on the repair of this F7 inverter. Thanks for watching.